We've heard from Angelina Jolie about the breast ovarian. Gilda Radner was another famous Hollywood star with a breast ovarian, and that is an important syndrome. But actually, Lynch syndrome is as prevalent as the breast ovarian cancer syndrome. And Lynch syndrome is very hard to explain in a few sentences because it's not just breasts and ovaries. It's actually brain cancer, stomach, duodenal, liver, gallbladder, kidneys, ureters, bladder, bowels, the uterus, and even some rare skin cancer. So Lynch syndrome, and I probably missed a few right there. Lynch syndrome is a wide spectrum that's traditionally was called hereditary non-polyposis colorectal carcinoma. That's a tongue twister. When it was originally discovered in families that had a lot of colon cancers. We've since learned that for women, the most common Lynch cancer they get is not colon, it's actually endometrial cancer. Ovarian cancer is also part of Lynch syndrome. So for us as GYN oncologists, the other important cancer syndrome to never forget is Lynch syndrome. It's not all about the breast ovarian. 10, 15, 20, 25% of cancers, depending on the syndrome, are caused by an inherited mutation. And if you think about the power of what we call the cascade effect, if you find one individual with a mutation and you draw out their family tree, and the way genetics works is things are passed down 50-50 chance, you know, roughly half the family members are also going to have that mutation. So one effort of paying attention to the family history, finding a cancer mutation, and then spreading that information to the family members can literally save lives. It sounds corny, but it gets back to the question of prevention. I mean, we all love to treat and cure cancers, but it's not that easy. Preventing cancer should be our supreme goal, and one of the most powerful tools we have now is the genetic information that gives us very advanced warning before the cancer has a chance to develop. One of the biggest tragedies I see is a patient who gets cancer and finds out later that some distant cousin was tested positive and they just never bothered to share the information. It's a tragedy because just a few emails and just getting the word out could have saved that person's life. And so those are the tragedies we're trying to prevent through awareness and getting people to stop fearing cancer. I call it unfear the unknown. And it sounds stupid, but that's really what it's about. There's a lot that's unknown about genes. There's a lot of fear, but we need to get over that and embrace it and not be afraid of the truth.
Do you know that not every breast cancer patient needs chemotherapy? Now there's a way to decide if chemotherapy will benefit you based on the unique biology of your tumor. To learn more about the Oncotype DX test and how to discuss it with your doctor, click this button.